Hello and welcome to the 15th installment of my grading of all of the base game cards. If you want insight into the grading system, check out the description or click on the link in the top right hand corner to get to the first video where I explain it all. But let's get started. To start off today's episode, I'm going to talk about Giant Ice Asteroid, one of the most influential cards in the entire game. GIA is one of the two big space events, with the other one being Demos Down. These two grant you so much control over the tempo of the game just by holding them. You can combo GIA with more temperature increases to fight for the bonus ocean. Also, if you have 4 plants before playing it, you can grab another 4 and place a greenery. And if you can place the greenery next to the oceans, you pay 32 MC for 5 TR, which is absolutely bonkers. But even if you cannot convert or you're intentionally going for minerals or cards with your oceans, GIA grants 4 TR in a single action, more than any other card on its own. This is incredibly relevant in the fight for Terraformer or Benefactor. Especially when I go for Terraformer, I always have one thought in the back of my head. What if my opponent has GIA? He could just steal that milestone from under my nose. So, we established that this card is super influential, and we haven't even talked about the plant destruction yet. Destroying 6 plants is super strong and can help decide gardener, landlord, or cultivator. A greenery is 3 points when placed next to a city, so in 2P, GAA is basically a 7-point swing or more if you prevent your opponent from placing one. Only Demos destroys more plants, but it is pretty rare that you actually get the chance to destroy 7 or 8 plants with that. And lastly, this card combos really well with Arctic Algae for a full greenery from scratch, as well as with all the other space discounts and event rebates. So yeah, I guess nobody's going to be surprised that GIA will land an S tier. Giant Space Mirror gives a slightly better conversion rate than Power Plant and Geothermal Power, both of which require exactly 7 MC for 1 Power Prod if bought in a draft. This difference is so minuscule that it doesn't even matter from a value standpoint though. What makes more of a difference are the reasons to play GSM or the other two cards. I'd say that in most games you'll be hard-pressed to find 3 strong, power-hungry cards that you want to play in quick succession in the early game. That means I see GSM more as a heat-producing card with the added flexibility of being able to play power-hungry cards with it. Power Plant and Geothermal Power are the other way around. You play them mainly to enable other cards, and only in rare cases, for example if you already established some heat prod, you'll play them as additional heat producers. But in general, GSM doesn't lose out on flexibility, it just has a bit of a different use case and it is still a C tier card for me. Really solid one in the early game. Grass is a unique card. The 3 plants it grants are super useful since they can allow you to save your plants from asteroids in the mid game or even enable you to place one more greenery in the last gen. Also, it is the earliest high value plant producing card on the temperature track. Nothing particularly good comes down at a lower temperature. This can be especially useful for insects or NRA. At the same time, of course, on its own it doesn't yield the same long-term power as bushes, for example, which is available a little bit later. It's a card that you sometimes play around, meaning that you will try to defer temperature bumps to minus 16 degrees to when your opponents have passed, just that they can only play this card one gen later, if they have it. You do the same with bushes, trees, farming, kelp or algae. And while this says a lot about the strength and consistency of grass, it is not quite in the same league as these cards. I think it is a C tier card. It has some unique and sometimes extremely useful features, but based on raw strength, it doesn't hold up to some of the other plant cards. I wish Great Dam would always come in its promo version. In its base version, it's just geothermal power, but you get a point for 1 extra MC, but you have to live with the restriction of only being able to play it at 4 oceans or higher. Oceans often come down super fast, and if that's the case, this card is quite nice. But in the early game, you're still not super excited to play this, since you do not really care about the point yet. I like to play this mainly in the mid to late game if I have steel prod and want to turn on city cards like Immigrant or Open City. Then it's just a straight up better deal than geothermal power. But all in all, it will also land in C tier. It has one pro over geothermal power, being the point, and 2 small cons, the 1 MC price increase and the restriction. Great Escarpment Consortium isn't nearly as devastating as AMC. Your opponent will only lose a steel prod which A is of less value generally and B tends to fall off in usefulness in the late game anyways. And then this card doesn't come with any tech or points, so its usefulness is limited outside of literally annoying the shit out of your opponent or winning Miner or Industrialist. AMC sometimes is even worth it to play in the last gen on yourself just to get the Jovian tech. It sounds like I'm only trash talking Great Escarpment Consortium, but it certainly has its uses, and sometimes you just need to cut it in a draft to avoid getting hit by it in the early game. But it's never a card I'd spec on in the starting 10, even if I had Steel Prod. Low C tier overall. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know in the comments whether you agree with my ratings or if not, how you would have rated them differently. Also, if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and consider subscribing. And lastly, please check out my Twitch and my Twitter. See you in the next video.